Hello, welcome everybody. This is Dr. Bolad, board certified physician in cardiology, interventional cardiology, and internal medicine, certified by the American Board of Internal Medicine. If you are new to this channel, then definitely consider hitting the subscribe button below and switch on the notification bell so you don't miss any new videos that I post. To my subscribers, thank you for your continued support. People with chronic gum disease and periodontitis have 2 to 3 times the risk of having a heart attack, stroke, and other cardiovascular diseases. However, not everyone with gum disease develops heart disease. A significant dose-dependent association between periodontitis and coronary heart disease was found in men less than 60 years of age, independent of other cardiovascular factors. Also, a significant association between the number of teeth at baseline and the risk of coronary heart disease exists, with participants with fewer teeth at baseline having higher incidence of coronary heart disease at follow-up. Insufficient sleep on the long term has a significant negative impact on health, especially cardiovascular health. The American Heart Association recognizes lack of adequate sleep as a risk factor for adverse cardiometabolic profiles and poor outcomes. Poor sleep is associated with the development of coronary artery disease among healthy middle-aged adults. Insufficient sleep is also a predictor of development of heart attacks, as demonstrated in this study. Insufficient sleep is also a predictor of development of cardiometabolic risk factors, including central obesity, high glucose, and high blood pressure. Insufficient sleep is a predictor of development of atrial fibrillation, which is heart arrhythmia manifested by irregularity of the heart beating. Cardiac disease complicates a small percentage of all pregnancies in developed countries, in the range of 1 to 4% of pregnancies in the United States. Maternal heart disease is a major cause of maternal morbidity and death. Pregnancy is associated with several cardiocirculatory changes that can significantly impact the heart. These changes begin early in pregnancy and reach their peak during the late second trimester and then remain relatively constant until delivery. Pregnancy can lead to peripartum cardiomyopathy. This leads to heart failure that affects women late in pregnancy or in the early puerperium. The cause of peripartum cardiomyopathy is unknown, with possible causes including altered prolactin processing, genetic, inflammatory, hormonal, hemodynamic, and autoimmune factors. The clinical presentation is similar to other forms of heart failure, with shortness of breath and accumulation of fluid in the lungs and other parts of the body, including the legs. High blood pressure can develop in pregnancy. This is referred to as gestational hypertension, and it is defined by the new onset of hypertension at or after 20 weeks of pregnancy. Most women with gestational hypertension have a drop in blood pressure to within the normal levels within the first week after delivery. If blood pressure returns to normal by 12 weeks postpartum, their diagnosis is changed to transient hypertension of pregnancy. If they remain hypertensive at the 12th week after delivery, they are given the diagnosis of chronic hypertension, which happens in approximately 15% of cases. Obstructive sleep apnea is a common sleep-related breathing disorder characterized by repetitive episodes in which breathing stops and starts. Patients with obstructive sleep apnea are often overweight, and studies have demonstrated a consistent association between sleep apnea and the occurrence of multiple heart diseases. Obstructive sleep apnea has been associated with the development of high blood pressure. A dose-response association between sleep disorder, breathing at baseline, and the presence of high blood pressure 4 years later exists, independent of known confounding factors. Obstructive sleep apnea is also associated with the development of coronary heart disease and heart failure. The severity of obstructive sleep apnea is an independent predictor of the incidence of atrial fibrillation hospitalizations. Atrial fibrillation is irregularity of the heart beating that predisposes individuals to clot formations in the heart and can lead to stroke. Independently, obstructive sleep apnea has been found to be strongly associated with ischemic stroke in men with mild to moderate sleep apnea. Depression is an independent risk factor for cardiovascular disease and cardiac health in otherwise healthy subjects. Multiple studies suggest that there is a severity-response relationship, such that the more severe depression is associated with greater risk of heart disease. Depression has been found to be associated with increased incidence of coronary artery disease, increased incidence of heart attacks, and increased incidence of cardiac death. If you have any question about what I presented to you today, then subscribe to my channel and share your question in the comment section below, and I will reply to you. If you have a question that you would not like to share in public, then follow me on Twitter at Dr. Bolad, and then send me a private Twitter direct message and I will reply to you. Please like and share this video with family and friends. This is Dr. Bolad, helping you with your heart health. Thanks for watching and talk to you soon.